So, day 6 of the Wim Hof Method for me. In China, this is 6. In China, they have a way of counting 1 till 10. You can only count it with one hand. I don't know, but 6 is this. So I wanted to add some classical music to my workout, especially now this one, not for the breathing, but for the push-ups, because it's fairly short and fairly intensive. And I just like to experiment with this. So I've selected 3 songs from Bach. I actually don't have any understanding about classical music. I just pulled in a name, Bach, and listen several songs and, or it's not songs, compositions, and I favorite 3, which I'm going to put on now. So I don't think we're going to listen all 3 during the workout, but at least I got some music in the background. Here we go.
Thank you.
actually like the music on the background. It might help to have a music in a rhythm, in a cadence of the breathing. I have the feeling like, and I'm not sure if I'm right, but I got the feeling like the cadence of the music changes over a while, and that that's where I kind of disconnected from the rhythm of the music, just follow my own breathing. I also didn't really count the amount of breaths what I took, because I'm not part of a scientific research or something. I just breathe until I feel like I reach the state that I want to be in. So I feel that my body is oxygenated and I start feeling the tingling. So I did 25 push-ups again today, yesterday 10, 25, and today 25. So it's going up, 15, 20, 20, 22, 25, 25. And that's fine for now, it's perfect. I'm sure in the next weeks it will go up. My body will get stronger and I will get more used to doing the Wim Hof Method breathing exercises. And these numbers will increase. And even though it's not the most essential part of the training, I just really want to get in shape. I've never really trained seriously, even though my dad was a licensed bodybuilding instructor. And I don't say I regret, but it is actually time to do something about it. So I'm really so freaking excited that I'm doing this. This is day 6. After tomorrow, celebrate a little bit in a healthy way. And there's two things what I'm celebrating, because yesterday I was 1 month without drinking coffee. And if you know that I would easily drink anywhere between 3 and 7 cups of coffee, decent big cups of coffee per day, then you can imagine that it wasn't always easy to not drink. So I'm really pleased with that. I have no intention to give up. I always do say it, like, never say never. I think it's not like some kind of holy grail that you can never ever drink something or eat something. Your body is very capable of handling a lot of things. I think the main thing is that you are very aware of what you put in your body, and that you do it in amounts that is still kind of healthy for your body. And let's say 4 or 5 cups of coffee a day is just not healthy. So that's it for today. I see you tomorrow.